Good morning.
Good morning. My name is Bob Silvestri. I'm the founder and president of Community Venture Partners, and it gives me no great pleasure to have to be here today to speak with you. As you know, we recently won a court decision about this board's violation of the Brown Act. The Brown Act is a cornerstone of democracy in California. It ensures the public's right to participate in government. So far, this board's response has been to generally complain and deny any wrongdoing. Supervisor Rice, you've said that you accept the ruling, but you refuse to acknowledge its truth. Supervisor Kinsey recently made a cosmetic attempt at an apology, essentially saying and echoing Mr. Woodside's argument that we didn't do it, but if we had done it, we would be very sorry and we would promise to not do what we didn't do again. Really? None of this excuses you, Supervisor Arnold and Supervisor Rice. You both owe the people of Marin an apology because the uncontested evidence in the trial showed that this was not done with good intentions and it was not done by mistake. In his ruling, Judge Chernis stated that he granted CVP declaratory relief because of the county's decision not to post the board's discussion on the agenda. The decision not to post it, not an oversight, not an error. At that unnoticed hearing, which you cheerily presided over, Supervisor Sears, this board had the audacity to counter the letter I had written criticizing the housing element. Ms. Arnold, you even went so far as to name our organization and to make prepared, disparaging remarks about us. So we filed our cease and desist, which you ignored, and then our complaint because you broke the law. The irony in all this is you could have avoided this long trial at any time and saved the taxpayers time and expense. All you had to do was admit what you did, promise not to do it again, and it all would have gone away. Instead, your attorneys unleashed what might be called a scorched earth approach, mounting some of the most disrespectful and frankly ridiculous legal arguments I've ever witnessed. Some say this is just evidence of how this board treats anyone who disagrees with it. But the truth is, Ms. Rice and Ms. Arnold, you got off easy because no depositions were taken in this case. You both filed affidavits in which you swore under oath that the hearing was completely spontaneous. But as the court recognized, your statements on videotape, Ms. Rice, clearly showed that you planned the discussion ahead of time. So please tell us, which of these is the truth?
Thank you for your
As comments. I said, I think you owe the people of Marin a real apology. Thank you.